terrorists and a foreign terrorist organization as well as possessing an unregistered destructive device. He will make his first court appearance tomorrow morning.
And we have seen report cards. And I think it's very important that the charges and voices as well as charges for the officers in Utah. Our Justice Court Executive Department are both on location at Kavanaugh's home with reaction from neighbors as well as insight from the former CIA covert operations officer.
Now, the FBI raised early this morning at the Glenville apartment complex that's on Curtis Street and just a block from Boroff High School. Students and family there were shocked by the police presence. Boroff back is still alive now.
Yeah, I was quite interested to see earlier today, Mark, where federal agents, police, and neighbors all gathered outside the apartment complex. So we heard from most neighbors that they were surprised this happened right here. FBI agents and protective suits milled in and out of this unit at the Glenbrook apartment complex. Some neighbors came outside to get a look at what was going on.
Well, I seen all the stuff going on all day today since very morning. When I found out what happened on the news, it was pretty crazy.
Jenny Timmons has lived in these apartments with her kids for the last year and a half.
My own son went to school right across the street, so at Fort Hines, so my kids were in the
hot. I missed you so much, you know. So, I know all these people.
The hot tongue is a Somali refugee. He lived here for 4 years and says about 80% of the residents are refugees.
There's a lot of, what refugee families do.
Again, we put out federal crime,
talking through some of these accusations that are being made here. A person in Idaho, the indictment alleges her not provided support to that foreign insurance by providing its services money and computer software. It also used that support in preparation for using in weapon attacks. Finally, last November, the charges accused them of having a destructive device that could be easily assembled. Now looking over at the Utah indictment, allegations are that Kerbanoff taught and demonstrated how to make explosives by showing internet videos, conducting instructional shopping trips, and providing lessons to make explosives. Claims are also doing this with the intent that his teaching would be used for violence, such as bombing and homeless place. And today we are on all four of those charges. Kerbanoff faces up to by 60 years in federal
prison.
We're going to continue our team coverage. We'll be doing a complete team report coverage in development on the news, online, and also at KTV.com.
And we should remind you that it's not part of the terrorism threat. We called the terrorist threat to the virus. And the Al-Qaeda was charged with providing material support to terrorists with greater equipment or charge.
All right, so we're going to see you on Monday. We'll have a temperature this weekend. You can expect this. What was that? Let's check in our last PCR district. Looking like possible wind showers out there.
We've got some out there. We'll take a look here at high storm front coming out from right ahead. You can see some showers on the district right off the I-4. We're not allowed to get there. And just to show you south of Mountain Cove, out toward Bruno, where we were earlier this week, you can see the rain showers down here over a wide county. And just about ready to move east of Mountain Cove, kind of across the freeway here. We could pick up on some of this. Just for this, we're looking southeast of Northeast. We're taking brighter showers that come out to the southwest. Just watch for that. There could be some scattered showers around the tonight. So the pitch path just kind of indicates some of the showers that are around the area at 11 o'clock. That shows that the showers look like they need to be mostly. Well, wait, we're going to have open paths. But my back here is going to have this white path. And then as we look at 6 o'clock, we can check for some red showers, get some more of that. How long is going to last?
If you consider something beyond smoke detection, my friend Hunter, then I can join Ray by an up close look at why that is the case that the entire country is facing.
Two small cells set up as living rooms, the room where experts say most deadly house fires actually start. Other than the color scheme, the only real difference between the two cells is this tiny fire sprinkler. Both will be set on fire, and then in a time demonstration, you'll see what a big difference that makes.
You can see that from the side.
First, with a sprinkler. A volunteer lights newspaper and sets behind the couch. Now watch and listen.
You know, there's a smoke detector, so how long does that take? Okay, just over 20 seconds.
The fire starts spreading.
Sure, it will get bigger and bigger.
About a minute and a half after the fire starts, the ceiling gets to 155 degrees.
There we go.
And trips the sprinkler.
The presentation is not to suppress or put the fire out, but it's